What's stealing my joy is this bumper-to-bumper traffic, but I'm going to get over it right now.
The Hot Sauce Cigar Box Guitar Kitchen, Mr. Fun Card,
presents Epic Fail of the Cigar Box Air Fiddler, Part 3.
Bro, I got to share this. It's Christmas and poetic and romantic that I finished this while listening to Athey Creek tonight by myself here in the workshop. Pretty much just followed dude's book. I didn't do all that, but and see how he has that nug down there. Instead of putting the nug down there, I put it, the spacer up here. But anyways, and then these were parts that you sent me, so thought that looked cool. Still waiting for this to dry, so just finish installing all this stuff right here, and then yeah, dude, boom. This is the first Fiddle, Watch and Pray, Hot Sauce Cigar Box Guitar Kitchen, all boxes signed Revelation 22:20. Behold, I come quickly, yo. Life is full of tension. You gotta learn to live in the tension, play under tension, build under tension, love our wives and our kids under tension. I was nervous about drilling those holes. He mentioned it in his book too, but I got a big video coming out for this. Well, not a big video, but that video will launch probably sometime next week. The one coming out tomorrow, dude, wait till you see the one tomorrow. But yo, bro, look. Pocket parts. Anyways, Merry Christmas, and I just share this with you because it was fun being able to finish this up. I'm waiting for this right here to dry. We keep our fingers crossed. I know tight bond's the bomb, but I might still put a screw in here. I don't know. That tight bond will hold a scarf joint angle, so I don't see why it won't hold this on here. But boom, hyped. Then up here is the bow. This just came. I got all the parts before. I just ordered this thing the other day. So excited about seeing how this comes out tomorrow. So this kind of goes down around here. This is drying. I freaking drilled that hole. That's a 5/16, but I should have drilled it a little smaller, but the glue should hold. And then you gotta like sand him down so he's here. Like that, dude. Boom. Then tomorrow we'll bust out the strings and see what happens. I don't know what this right here is. This is supposed to be the chin rest, but I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. He didn't really mention this in the book, so let's keep him aside. Anyways, Merry Christmas. It's midnight. We're looking for our Lord. He can come any time. Peace. Pinecone Wallace and the Walnuts, the 17th annual farewell reunion tour. So the band's age, they've grown. Some of them have some, they've had some work done, you know, some plastic surgery. They don't want to talk about it. I'd say 3/4 of the band are now completely sober. Old Wally Walnuts still, you know, he's working on some issues, you know. He's fallen off the wagon a couple thousand times, but the band still, you know, got his back. They are going on their farewell tour once again. It's okay, though. The fans demand it. And they are, you know, they're a band of the fan. You know, they're a band of the fans. So their new album, Smile, comes out on vinyl, CD, and cassette, and VHS, and 8-track. Year 2024, so stay tuned. This would be referring to page 25. Again, nothing real special happening here. I'm following my dude's lead here because I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing. So we're just going to follow his instructions. The Hot Sauce Cigar Box Guitar Kitchen presents, no, How I Built a Cigar Box Fiddle, How the Hot Sauce Cigar Box Guitar Kitchen Built a Fiddle, using the book by Nick Lanciano from CB Giddy, I believe this video will be the third and final installation. The neck glued overnight. I finished this last night. Well, you can't, I mean, this video is gonna be probably, it'll be immortal, lost in the YouTube ethosphere. But anyways, as it relates to last night, finished it, got it all laid out. The neck is dried and I'm gonna string it up. I have absolutely no idea how to string it up. I'm gonna refer to the book and then I'm gonna string it up. So we're gonna put this on, what is that called? Time lapse, and we'll see what happens. Sucks, Mike. This one broke. Ignorance is not bliss. So now I'm gonna go to the violin loft and go get this string. Guess this would be a good time for me to just show them my hack work. Anyways, it's okay, don't freak out. This is the first time I've ever done this, so I'm not gonna, I mean, that it broke is just, yeah. All right, but in the meantime, let's just, we'll go get a string real quick. There's a violin store right up the road. Maybe I'll get a job there. Building cigar box violins. All right, so maybe I. Ah. Addicted son of a bitch, I've read a parafragamusha. Yeah, it's the truth. I know the videos are wacky and crazy and whatever, dude, but this or this kind of stuff just makes me want to get right out of the spirit and right up in the flesh talking about Yosemite Sam. All right, friction pegs, huh? Trippy how it goes out, out real fast. Alright, I'm gonna go get a string and then we'll come back. Let's go on an adventure. Mike, you ready to do this thing? Don't be scared, Mike. Alright, look, we don't got a lot of time to spare. They close at 5:30. 4:57. Alright, we're gonna take the spirit of old Saint Nick Lanciano. I'm talking about a little Lanciano. All right, we're gonna take Nick over here with us, and I busted this string. It's not Nick's fault. Ignorance is not bliss. So I busted the green string. We go there and see if they had that string real quick, and see if they, what do they think about my work. All right, check it out. I finished that last night. This and this are Puckett parts. Did you see the Del Puckett care package video? Go check out Del Puckett videos where he sends a care package to the Hot Sauce Guitar Podcast. Listen, if I could have named this channel a longer name, I'm working on it, dude. The Hot Sauce Cigar Box Doomsday Bunker Guitar Lighthouse Food Truck. I listened to Athey Creek last night, the Christmas special, and then I put these on here. And look, I accentuated see the middle part there in the F hole? That was hard to do, dude, cutting that right there. So I didn't want to cover my work up. It's usually where I blow it. It came out pretty good, but I don't know. I just thought I was inspired last night. I don't know. I thought the blue right here goes to the blue here. We'll see. But enough jibber jabber and yam yakking and lollygagging. Let's go to the violin loft. It really is off-putting, dude. It's like 5 o'clock, this winter time change they do. They gotta stop doing this to people. It's like 5 o'clock, it's gonna be dark here at 6. It's like right now I'm like looking, you know, like it's the sun setting, or you can't tell on this camera, it looks like because of the iris of the camera, but it's like dark out. It'll be dark here in an hour at 6 o'clock. It's just off-putting. Don't listen to the van's trying to force me to put my seatbelt on, dude. And nobody tells the Hot Sauce Guitar Kitchen what to say, think, feel, or do. Not even my own van. All right, here we are, the violin loft.
right next to Robbie's Hobbies. Did you see that video when we went to Robbie's Hobbies? The Lionel Trains? It's back in the video somewhere. And then right next to the Beach Wall Bicycles. I need to get a bicycle this year, dude. Ooh, an Eagle Family Candy. Don't go up in there and get no chocolate, dude. I've already eaten like more cookies and cake and pie in the last 3 days, and it's not even Christmas yet, dude. Kind of pride of myself on losing a bunch of weight, and I'm just gonna, all right, I'm gonna park here and let's do this thing. It's only 5 o'clock rush hour traffic. This is a wonderful time to come out here. Listen, yeah, the older I'm getting, the more traffic is just eating away at a brother's nerves. Ask my wife, ask my girls. I'm not grumbling and complaining, I kind of am, but the traffic is just like teeth grinding.
Dude, check it out. It's even a cult building. Look up there. Dang. Violin Loft, Columbus, Ohio. I'm gonna roll up in here. This dude gave me, this guy Travis in here, their tech. He gave me some bass strings when I made a stand-up bass out of a wine box. I gave it to my dude over there that when I used to work at Lucky's. This guy plays bluegrass music. And this guy, Travis, gave me some free strings. So, dig, let's go in here and see what they think about this. I need the third string. They better not laugh at me, dude. I'm a very sensitive person. I'm very sensitive. If they laugh at me, I'm gonna start crying and run out of here. Hot Sauce Cigar Blast Guitar Kitchen here at the Violin Loft, Columbus, Ohio. I popped that string, this book by Nick. Yo, bro, when you see this video, I popped the string and I brought it to this, check this place out. It's super cool. I'm gonna try to have someone who knows what they're doing actually make noise on it, because I have no idea what I'm doing. So, but over here, the kind folks are gonna string this up for me real quick and just to see if this thing works. Yo, look at that. So I guess in some ways, Nick, I'm glad I popped the string, because I was never gonna come here today. But we're gonna try to get this to make just noise. All right, height. So I popped this string right here, and then I brought it here to the Violin Loft, and I'm having these kind folks just check it out. It's real, this is my first one. I don't really know what I'm doing, but none of us did.
I can see one problem.
Yes?
You're not gonna play the E string or the G string without running into the side of your instrument.
That's what these bow cuts are for then, huh?
You're gonna hit that. You can kind of do it. Yes. You have to be really careful, but you don't have too much clearance. So
that's why you have to have
it. The space here is about 111 millimeters, and you've got probably the width of a violin like 165.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. So that's what. So the answer to this question right here, because I skipped this stage right here because I thought that this was just for aesthetics. This is actually necessary because. Like you're saying, you have to have a place to dive the bow in. Okay.
I mean, you can kind of do it, and you could always make the bridge high enough to make sure that you can do it, you know.
Speaking of the bridge, is my bridge high enough? Because I actually trimmed it down. It was about 3/8 yeah. higher. Is that too low, or is that high enough?
Well, fortunately, you left very flat. So you might find it difficult to play one string at a time without
right.
bumping into all the other strings.
Right.
So if I did, but had you curved it enough that you had plenty of clearance, there's no way you could have played these.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Because you had to, you know, clear these strings. So.
Cool.
It sort of works the way you've got it. You can.
Listen.
But you're going to have to be very accurate not to.
Right.
Not to get cool. double stops on the string.
All right, cue Alice in Chains. Alice in Chains. It's just another lesson learned. How to come a believer. So yeah, there's the waist, the little things. I should have followed Nick. See, I try to be crafty guy and put the F holes in here. And you know, you have to have those. That's my takeaway now for if you're gonna build one of these cigar box violins, you have to have those, the little wastings, that's for your bow. That's where you dive in and dive out. So, dude said it'll work, and just like Nick, this was my first attempt, and his first attempt was whatever it was. He's gonna go back to it.
I'm not interested in doing this again, tell you the truth. But it was a blast to do. And yeah, this work, it makes noise and you can hang it up and it'll look cool. So thank you, CB Giddy. All right, thank you, CB Giddy. Thank you, Nick Lanciano. Thank you for your book. And yeah, man, super fun. Yeah, man, every time that Alice in Chains song, it's just another lesson learned. Every time I go through these situations, that's the song that comes to my head. Yeah, dude. So those guys were kind. Yeah, you had to have that. That's the takeaway. I mean, it's still worse. Maybe I was busted out like a... Did you see the end of Master and Commander when they're jamming in the captain's lounge? Yeah, dude, this was a super fun thing to do. I probably won't do it again, but if you do want to do it again, definitely do your research, do your homework, get your parts from CB Giddy, get Nick Lanciano's book, and if he does updates or whatever, get those future ones. Nick, if you do this again and again and again, bro, just keep doing it. I'll keep buying your books just because it's fun to do. Once again, my takeaway from those guys was, I'm completely ignorant about this, and I'm completely driving in rush hour traffic with my knee. That's just because I'm a dynamic driver. What can I say? Yeah, you have to have those things. The guy's saying for your bow. I thought it was just aesthetics. That just shows the ignorance of the Hot Sauce Cigar Box Guitar Kitchen as it relates to fiddles. But I'm hyped. What's stealing my joy is just bumper-to-bumper traffic, but I'm going to get over it right now. I might go to Arby's and get 5 for $5 roast beef sandwiches, to tell you the truth, because I'm hangry. All right, wrapping it up, done. I'm going to go back to the shop now and just take the bow that I got and at least make noise with this thing. And whatever. Super cool. Happy holidays. All right, let me go back to using my hands to drive. Peace. Did you dig it? Keep oil in your lamps, my friends. Watch and pray. Dude, I don't know what this guy's talking about. You had to have those bow things on there. I can play this thing, dude. This is the way it is. I can play cigar box guitar. I don't know why I can't play this the way it is. Huh. Well, look. This thing plays great, man. The way it is. YouTube videos, and I think I can figure out how to play this thing pretty good. Brown sugar, powdered sugar, active dry yeast, green bean casserole. Ugh. One can of condensed cream and mushroom. Oh, we gotta make green bean casserole again, dude. Seriously.
Sawing on the fiddle and playing it hot, and the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I've got a fiddle of gold against your soul, because I think I'm better than you." The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet, and you're gonna regret, because I'm the best as ever been."
Johnny, rousing up your bow and play your fiddle hard. Cause hell's broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, you get the shiny fiddle made of gold. But if you lose, the devil gets your soul. And he said, I'll start this show. And fire flew from his fingertips as he rosined up his bow. And he pulled the bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss. And then a band of demons joined in and it sounded something like this. Well, you're pretty good, old son. But sit down in that chair right there and let me show you how it's done. Fire on the mountain, run, boys, run. The devil's in the house of the rising sun. Chicken in the bread pan, picking out dough. Ready as your dog bite, no child, no. Bowed his head because he knew that he'd been beat. He laid that golden fiddle on the ground at Johnny's feet. Johnny said, devil, just come on back if you ever want to try again. I done told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best there's ever been. He played, fire on the mountain, run, boy, run. Devil's in the house of the rising sun. Chicken in the bread pan, picking out dough. Apparently you don't find no child, no.
Time.